Hello, my name is Jessica Tipton, and I'm an associate professor and librarian at Johnson County Community College. Today, we're going to talk about how to turn a research question into a strategy. There are a number of reasons that we do this. It not only leads you to more relevant articles faster, it also will save you some time and give you more time to work on your research paper. So there are four steps that we look at when we're talking about this. The first being background reading. Two is identifying keywords. Step three is to come up with search strategies. And step four is to identify the library resources you'll be using for your research. So first, background reading. Background reading is important because it's very difficult to do research on a topic that you don't fully understand. So there are a couple different places that you look for information. You might look in your textbook. You might do an internet search, see what's out there. And then, of course, using the library resources. So you might look in a dictionary, get some definitions of terms. You might look at an encyclopedia, read a brief overview, read an article or a book chapter. But just having that understanding of that topic makes the research go so much better. After that, we'll talk about how to identify keywords. Let's take an example topic from the National Speech and Debate Association and go through an example. So the first thing we need to do is identify the keywords or key terms in this sentence. So for that, we would say illegal drugs. We're looking for important terms, or usually nouns, throughout our sentence or question. Illegal drugs, public health, criminal justice. Abuse would be a good one to use too. And then I go over and I think of some other keywords that I might use based on this question, based on some of my background reading. So I might add in treatment, because we have the word treated over there, but treatment's going to work better than treated in a search. Maybe I'm interested in a specific population, like teenagers. I might be interested in what's going on in Kansas. Or I might also look at certain types of drugs. So I could look at opioids. After I do this, I start thinking about what search strategies can I use, because I'm not just going to throw these keywords into a library database. I'm going to take some time to create search strategies. And there are a couple things that are really useful with creating search strategies. So quotes are one of my favorites. And I put quotes around key terms, key phrases, words that I expect to stay together and I want to stay together. So public health, for example, I would put quotes around that because I want public and health to be right together in my article. I don't want public to be in the top of my article and then the word health to be at the bottom with no connection between them. Other things I use for creating search strategies are Boolean terms, such as and, or, and not. And these are words that I use to combine my key terms, my keywords, and I put them in caps. It's always very useful to keep them in caps. It helps you know where you've put them into your search strategy. Plus, this way works in the library databases and other online resources. If you do them in lowercase, they don't always work. So you wanna go ahead and put them in caps. So then I go ahead and start combining terms and my search strategies and create some great ways to actually get into the library resources. So I might say, you know, I really want to know about illegal drugs. So I'll take that from my topic at the top. So I'll say illegal drugs in quotes. I want that to stay together. And then I'm going to take one of my Boolean terms from here. So I'll say and. And then I'll pick a different keyword to add to it. So I might want to say illegal drugs and treatment. So I'm taking terms from my sentence. I'm taking key terms that I've come up with. Plus I'm combining, I'm using the quotes to keep that together. And then I'm also, you know, using my Boolean terms to come up with a search strategy that I can use in the library resources and get right to the articles that match my topic. The word not is another one I use quite a bit, and we'll talk about how that works. So I'll erase the word and. I'll put the word not in there instead. So if I say illegal drugs, not treatment, then I'm getting articles that are about illegal drugs, but not the treatment side of things. So using these terms, just it's telling the computer, telling the library database, this is what I want. It's taking the time to create this will get you to your more relevant articles that actually match your topic and help you with your research and writing your paper quite a bit faster. After I come up with my search strategies, I'm ready to go to the library resources and start my research. I might look in Summon, the search box on the library website that searches through almost everything we have access to. I might go to the individual library databases, smaller, more focused collections of articles and books, or I might try the library catalog to get right to the books we have in the library. It all depends on my topic and the direction I want to go with my research. Not sure where to start? Check with one of the librarians. We're happy to point you in the right direction. You can come and visit us at the Ask Here desk on the first floor of Billington Library, or find us online through our Ask a Librarian website. I hope that this video helps you get started with your research process. Please let us know if you need help.